Sometimes when you're crafting in Design Space, you might have a very specific design in mind that you wish to create, but you can't find a suitable image for it to use. When this happens, there is something that you can do to customize the existing images in Design Space to create something that perfectly fits your vision, and that is by combining several images together to create something new. Let's see how it works. Hello and welcome to Design Space Daily, helping you learn Cricut Design Space in short and snappy video tutorials. On the screen I've got two images that I found in Cricut Access. I've got a horse and an angel wing, and I'm going to combine these together to create a kind of Pegasus unicorn design. The first thing to do is to get everything the same colour, because that'll make it easier when you're trying to put them together to see how it's going to look. You could go into the colour at the top and make them all the same in there. Or if you've got lots of different images that are all different colours, an easier way to do it is to go to the colour sync button on the top right of your screen and then drag all of your images onto one colour and drop, and that'll make them all exactly the same colour. Once you've done that, click back to layers to see your layers again, because we're going to need them. I'm going to make the horse a little bit bigger so it's easier to see, and also the wings. I want to add the wings to the back of the horse, so I'm going to need to flip them first. So go into flip in the top and flip horizontal. That's a great little tool to learn, because if you find an image that is kind of what you want but you'd rather it was facing the other way, you can flip it really easily just with that button. You can also flip images vertically. It's going to make this bigger, and now drag and drop it to position it on the horse. You may need to rotate your images to get them showing exactly where you want them. Okay, so now I've got my Pegasus looking good, but I want to add that nice little unicorn horn. To do this, I'm just going to go into shapes and then triangle. So as well as combining images, we can also combine shapes. I need to unlock the proportions by clicking the padlock icon, and that means I can resize it to make a unicorn horn shape. Now I can just drag that into the middle of the horse's head, and it's turned into a unicorn. Just going to move it tiny bit and rotate it to make it a bit more obvious. There we go. Alright, so you might think that's all you need to do. However, when you click make it to send it to your Cricut machine, you can see it's got all of the bits separate. It hasn't connected them all together. So cancel out of that, and we need to make them all stick together. Now, you might be thinking that the way to do this is by clicking it all and then pressing attach. However, that's not going to work, because it will be hard to see in all the same colour. So if I just change the colour, you can see a bit better now. It's got the lines on it. So what this is going to do now it's attached is, although when we click make it, they're now all joined together, you can see that it's still got these cut lines in the wings and around the triangle. So it's still going to cut that out as a full triangle. So you're going to end up with three separate pieces and not one finished unicorn design. So I'm going to go back to here and just undo that attach. There we go. And instead, what you need to do is select all your layers. So click one in the layers panel, press Control on your keyboard and click all the others. And then instead of attach, we want to click weld. Now be careful with weld, because once you've done it, it's it, that's fixed forever. So if I welded it and then closed the project and opened it again, I wouldn't be able to then just move the angel wings without the horse. Because I've welded it, it's kind of stuck together forever. So if you think you might want to change it at another point, the easiest thing to do is to group your layers, pressing group, and then click on the top of the group and right click and duplicate. So we've now got another version, which I'm just going to hide by clicking the little eye icon. So if I ever need to change it again, I've got that original one there that isn't welded, so I can make those changes. But for now, I'm going to go into the one that's still visible and then click on weld. So what that's done is it's joined all those images together. If I change the color, you can see that now we don't have those cut lines around the edge of the wings or in the horn. So it's now just one solid image, which is going to cut out perfectly. You'll notice that where the wings and the mane are joined here, there's a tiny little speckle. This can happen when you weld. You'll start to notice little bits in the design that you didn't see before. And this is going to be a tiny little cut that my Cricut isn't going to be able to do because it's just too small. So if you get things like that, the way to fix it is to click your image and then press the contour button. Find those tiny little bits and then just click on them and it will remove them. So now that's gone. And this is now ready for me to cut out. So if I click make it, it is really big. I've made it too big for a Cricut to cut. So let me just make it smaller. There we go. So now you can see that it's all ready to cut. It's going to cut beautifully all around the edge. And we have now created something brand new out of those original two images and one shape. You can do the same thing with lots of different images to create scenes rather than just one image. So for example, I've got all of these images which I found earlier in Cricut Access, and I'm going to arrange them together to create a pretty scene of the wolf howling at the moon surrounded by lots of different trees. And this is really nice if you're trying to recreate something you found online. So maybe you've seen a t-shirt with a howling wolf and you want to make one similar, but you want to have your own design input and create it from scratch yourself. This is a great way to learn how to do that. So I'm just going to ungroup these so I can move everything. And then I'll start with the rock I've got here and then drag my wolf in. So just like I did before with positioning the wings on the horse, I'm just doing the same. So moving things about so that I'm happy with the position of how it's all looking. And you don't need to keep everything joined up. So I'm going to keep the moon separate and then build up the images one at a time to create my finished scene. Alright, so I'm very nearly done. Just going to add that grass in there. And there we go. So that was very quickly done. But you can see already just how that is going to allow you to create new designs of the images in Cricut Access by positioning them all together. And we need to do exactly the same thing we did before. We need to weld these. So I'm going to select all of my layers and then press weld down the bottom. And now it's all one thing. And again, I've got a tiny little speckle in that tree, which I need to contour out. If you're not sure how to use the contour tool, I've got a separate video on that. So I'll link it in the description of this one so that you can go check that out if you need a little bit of a helping hand with the contour tool. But here is my wolf image. If I click make it, I've made it too big again. I need to pay more attention. Okay, here we go. So you can see it's going to cut it all as one around the edge. So this is perfect for if I was cutting it out from cardstock or if it was going to be vinyl to go on a t-shirt all in one colour. So I hope this video has shown you a little bit about how you can use the images in Design Space and Cricut Access to create new things so that you can be more creative with your designs and create images and scenes which perfectly fit your creative vision. So thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. I release new Design Space videos every week, so subscribe to my channel to make sure you never miss any, or visit my website at craftwithsarah.com for lots of free SVGs and Cricut projects. Thank you for watching.